Hi everyone. Today is going to be the third lecture of the second week for this semester. Crystallography part two. We have learned all these topics already. Seven crystal systems with 14 Bravais lattices, theoretical density, and the packing factor for hexagonal close packed, real and reciprocal lattices. Last time, you already know, once you know the real crystal structure, how to construct the reciprocal lattice, right, in the reciprocal space by using the formula that I already showed to you. And B1, B2, and B3, remember, they are primitive vectors in reciprocal space. And today you will learn that the B1, B2, and B3 is important for these topics. Mirror indices, how that related with mirror indices. And by knowing mirror indices, how you can specify the lattice directions and lattice planes by using mirror indices, including what is the meaning of interplanar spacing or despacing. Okay. This slide, instead of they use B1, B2 and B3, they use A star, B star, and C star for primitive vectors in reciprocal space. So this is called reciprocal space lattice vectors. You can use R star is HKL. Later on, you will know this HKL is just mirror indices. So it's just some number, right? Right now. And this is like B1, B2, and B3 for our symbols. But these slides, they use A star, B star, and C star. And here they said, okay, this is equal to D star subscript HKL. The reciprocal space lattice vectors form an orthonormal set is like this. So A star dot with B equals A star dot with C, where in this case, they use A, B, C for primitive vectors in real space. So by using the orthonormal set, you see that this is different dot product gives us zero. And for the same, but in real, and reciprocal space dot product has to be the same, gives us one. That's similar for B star and C star as well if you change this. And we can define a reciprocal unit cell with volume V star. So this one I already talked last time. In our slide is B1 dot B2 cross B3. And here they use R stars for reciprocal space. And V star dot V is one. Okay, so this is in real, right? In real space. So you already know the position vector, right? Some number, integer numbers, and A1, A2, and A3. And here they use A, B, C. Again, this is like H, K, L. And this is A star, B star, and C star. So this is supposed to be H, K, L. So that's the typo. Okay, great. This is the equations that I already mentioned from the last lecture. It's like how to convert to primitive vectors in reciprocal space, right, by using this formula. And notice that A star is perpendicular to AB plane. There is AB plane, right? Look at in this form, it's perpendicular to AB plane. So the cross product, I'm not sure if you are familiar with the math or not. I already asked you to review by yourself, right? Okay, dot product A dot B. So this become scalar. A dot B is absolute of A times absolute of B. Cosine theta and is scalar. And for cross product, A cross B is the same as absolute value of A times absolute value of B psi theta, where theta here is the angle between A and B. And here, the angle again is the angle between A and B. And the direction here is always perpendicular to the plane that formed by A and B. So that's how they describe this here. So C star, right? So A cross B has to be a vector that is perpendicular to AB plane, right? This is AB plane. Could be something like that, okay? Okay, so now, when you use D star HKL dot together here, okay? So this is this vector dot with this vector, and by dot product from the definition A star dot B star, because cosine 90 degree gives you zero. So this is zero, and left with A star, right, dot A star. So from here, you will end up with this. So only this term matters. So when you do dot product, right? So this term exists. And A star dot A star is 1/A². And B star dot B star is 1/B². And C star dot C star is 1/C². So at the end, so this is 1/DHKL star is this relationship. You will see this when we learn XRD again, okay? But notice that later we're gonna learn what is really HKL, okay, HKL. This is in general. So when we have angle between plane, normals H1, K1, L1, and H2, K2, L2, the angle between two vector is cosine rho is A dot B over AB. And this is the math here, okay? So this one will work for what? For simple cubic, tetragonal, and orthorhombic. We come back again when we learned about XRD. Okay, so let's say talk about the Ewart sphere. Ewart sphere is a geometry construction invented by Paul Peter Ewart, a German physicist and crystallographer. Is used to demonstrate the relationship between the wave vector of the incident beam K. So this is K. So you have the incident beam K and the wave vector of the refracted beam K prime. So this is K prime. And the diffraction angle to theta. So the angle between K and K prime is 2 theta here. For a given reflection plane HKL in the reciprocal lattice of the crystal. The Edwards sphere is useful in electron, neutron, and X-ray crystallography. If the diffraction in the crystal is elastic, energy will be conserved, no gain or lost in the process, so that both wave vectors for the incident X-ray beam and the diffracted X-ray beam have the same magnitude. So this is 2π/λ. So this is the same magnitude for K and K prime, where K is the wave vector of the incident beam and K prime is the wave vector of the diffracted beam. And lambda is just the wavelength of X-ray beam, okay? So when you construct like this, and it's certified with Laud condition. What is Laud? Laud condition? K prime minus K is G. And G, okay. I want you to take a look at G here. So this is certified when intensity of elastic scattering peak is maximum. So what is G related to HKL, and remember here, B1, B2, and B3, they are what? Primitive vectors in reciprocal space, right? And HKL is mirror indices. So notice that G, we call it a reciprocal wave vector, and is perpendicular to the plane HKL. So think of this, right? So you have X-ray beam coming, this is K vector and K prime, right? Direction is like that, and this is G. So look at this. So this is G, reciprocal wave vector, again, perpendicular to the plane of HKL. So this is this plane, D is the spacing or interplanar spacing. Okay, great. So now let's talk about mirror indices. Mirror indices are used to specify directions and planes. These directions and planes could be in lattices or in the crystal. The number of the indices will match with the dimension of the lattice or the crystal. So let's introduce this. So they use different symbols. If you use open like this, right, just normal bracket. So this represent crystal plane. Curly one represent a family of planes or equivalent planes. That means like same lattice spacing. And a square bracket represents crystal direction. And the triangle bracket that represents a family of directions or equivalent directions. I mean, the same direction we represent using the like a triangle bracket. Okay, great. So why we have to really learn about mirror indices? I mean, if you are researchers doing research related to synthesis materials or even like characterized materials, you oftentimes see that your material will come sometimes, right, with the mirror indices like this, or even like around the materials that you want to synthesize. For example, if you want to grow thin films to the substrate, right? The word grow films is very common in practice. So let's I make you a drawing. So when you have a substrate, So this is substrate. And you want to grow the films on top of this, right? Sometimes, if you want to control the quality of the film, you can control by making the substrate to induce the crystal orientation of the films. For example, you might say, okay, the substrate, look, I bought the single crystal substrate, right? So this one, they have to come with HKL to match, right, to match with the in-plane lattice. For example, if you zoom in-plane lattice of the film could be like this. For example, so this one, I'm looking at in plane, okay? And then for the substrate, example, maybe a little bit bigger. Example, something like that, okay? Okay. So this in plane of the film, in plane lattice of the film, in plane lattice of the substrate. So this try to match up with this, right? That is one way to control the quality of the crystal in the films. And look, they have to say, okay, when I buy it, you have to tell me what direction do we want to buy. So this is 100 plane and 110 plane. Silicon is 100, germanium is 111, and so on, for example, something like that. And now let's learn how to build up what is HKL, okay? You can read all this by yourself. Let's see. So set the desired plane and look at where it intersects XYZ in multiples of the lattice constant. The simplest case are cubic lattice for which the lattice constant is the same in all directions. And then take the reciprocal of each intersection point and divide it out by a common integral to obtain the lowest three integral values and put those integrals in the parentheses as ABC. Note that if the plane doesn't intersect with an axis, otherwise parallel to that axis, let's say Z axis, the number in the first place will be infinite. And after converting them, you will get AB0. Okay, you will see in a second. I mean, might be confusing to read this. And here again, if the intercept is in negative side of an axis, say the x-axis, just put a bar over the number. For example, A bar BC or minus ABC. Okay, so let's take a look. Look at this. What is this plane? What is the mirror indices, HKL, that represent this plane? So you write down X, Y, Z intercept. X hit at number two, right? One and two. Y intercepts 1, 2, 3, 4. Write down number 4 here. Z intercept 1, 2. Put 2 here. And the second row, you inverse it, right? Or reciprocal of the number. 1/2, 1/4, 1/2. And now you multiply by 4, you get the minimum number as possible. So you multiply by 4, you get 2, 1, 2. So the mirror indices for this plane is 2, 1, 2. Okay, great. So now let's look for more. Okay, this is very easy. X intercept is 1, right? Y intercept, no intercept, is parallel to y axis, put infinity. How about Z intercept? No, again, it's parallel, right? See here, is parallel to z-axis. This is z-axis. So put infinity here. And then after converting this number, you will get 100. So this is the plane here for cubic. So B, what is plane? What is HKL? X intercept is 1. Y intercept is 1, right? X intercept is 1. Y intercept is 1. But parallel to Z axis or never hit any number on Z axis. So it's infinity. And then you convert it to the mirror indices by reciprocal these numbers, right? You get 100, because 1/∞ is 0 here. 1/∞ is 0. Okay, great. Again, for C, parallel to X, parallel to Y, we put infinity, infinity, and then cut C as 1. So when you inverse, right, 1/∞, you get 0, 1/∞, you get 0, 1/1, you get 1. So this is 0, 0, 1, this plane. How about this one? This is obvious, right? All the intercepts in X, Y, Z is 1, 1, 1. And then you reciprocal those numbers, 1/1, 1/1, 1/1, you get 1, 1, 1. This is easy. Okay, now move to lattice directions. We use the symbol square bracket HKL. So this is just like, think about like a vector position, something like that, okay? So for example, this vector, right? So this point, right, is sitting on X is 1, Y is 1, C is 1, then you project from origin to 1, 1, 1. For example, something like that, okay? And for this one, let's look at this one first. This one is X is 1, Y is 1, C is 0. So that's right, this is 1, 1, 0. Okay, so now move to this one. This one is the same direction as this. Okay, now think about, have another origin here. Okay, and this, right? So Z is 1, X 0, Y 0. So anything that parallel to this vector, we will have the same direction. So you have to think about like at the origin here, right here. And how about this one? So if you continue this arrow like that, right? you will know that this will hit X is 2 and Y is 1. And never hit 0. So this is 0. So it's 2, 1, 0. How about this one? Hit Y at what? 1, right? And never hit X and C is 0, right? C is 0 and X is 0. And anything that parallel to that is 0, 1, 0 direction. Okay. This is the tables that represent members in family. For example, for 100, right? 100. So you have the same. So this is a family, right? This is family. So with the minus here, and you can move because it's cubic, move one to here. And move the minus side to here, and move one to here, and move the minus one to here. Okay. Okay, this is extra knowledge, but if some of you work on hexagonal system, you will know that the HKL is no longer 3 numbers. It's gonna be 4 mirror indices. So it's gonna be HKIL, where H plus K need to be minus I. So this is A1, right? A2, and this is A3. See, do you see here? So this is minus A3, right? It's like a minus I here, but A3 is point that way, opposite to minus A1. So A1 again, A2, and when you do the, think about like a vector, right? A1 plus A2, you get this, right? But another word is A3 that way, okay? So that's how H plus K is minus I. It may be a little bit difficult for you to picture, but let's go together again. Instead of HKL, right? Now you have an extra one here. See? So before you have only like 1 and 2 and 3, right? But you have the I here in the middle. And the property is like H plus K has to be minus I, like that, okay? Because these two vector is that way, right? When you add up these two vector, but to represent the whole hexagonal system, you need in that direction A3. So that's why it's this A3 that way. And this is C. So for example, the plane. Parallel, 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 but cut Z at one. So this is really simple, right? Or even like cut A2 at the minus A2, right? Minus A, let's say. So this is it. So this is this plane. And the direction as well, give you some examples. So this one, like a vector that passing point 1, 0, 0, right? Use the bracket. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. How about 2 here? Two here is 0 and 1 and 1, right? On this plane here. Okay, I will give you the homework. Could be some of these pictures, and then you have to be able to explain to me why they are written like this. Okay, so now please do that like an exercise. So I think this week will be done, and next week we will start talking more about X-ray diffraction technique and more of like the despacing, right? HKL, you will see that the stuff that we have learned so far, you will see that now you will be able to use them in real research application, or even like try to characterize or predict something. Okay, I think today that's about it for today. See you. Bye.